Hi, I'm Shania Matthews, a lead reviewer at the CAGBC. Today's reviewer insight session is illustrating solutions to avoid the most common errors we see in the review for heat island reduction under LEED building design and construction, both V4 and 4.1. The goal in this video is not to walk through how to document this credit, but instead we will do a quick focus on three common submission errors, which all happen to be in option one. The first issue we commonly see is with the total project areas, which make up the denominator in the equation. Let's take a look at the form in LEED Online. The form handles many of the calculations for you. Most project teams start with the form to confirm compliance. However, unlike other forms, it's easier to actually start at the end of the form to think about the site holistically. Once you select option one and your units, start scrolling down. And then down some more, all the way to the last table under option one, which is the summary of non-roof and roof. This summary table is the ideal place to start. Why? Because it's important to consider all impacted areas on your site. There are two places to enter data into the summary table: for total project paving area and total project roof area. Basically, once you get this denominator right in the equation, it is easier to understand the values that will go into building the numerator. How do we as reviewers confirm the denominator? In your LEED project site plan, consider all the hard surfaces on your site, including the parking lots, pathways, courtyards, and the complete roof, except for the mechanical equipment. One common area that gets missed in this calculation is planter boxes, sketched here in green within our courtyard. Where you have planter boxes covering the hardscape and acting as shade, you will need to include the area under those planter boxes in your total project paving area. If we go back to our site plan, for our total paved area, we want to be sure we include the total paved courtyard, including the area covered by these green planter boxes. Lastly, with regard to site area, ensure that the LEED boundary is consistent with the other credits impacting the boundary. And it's not just about the LEED boundary itself, but of course, ensuring all hardscape and softscape areas are the same. The second common error is double counting areas. Once you have the totals for the denominator in the summary table, you can now jump back to the start of the form to fill in your different hardscape and roof areas for each strategy applied. Most of the entries are self-explanatory, but we sometimes find double counting of areas when you add up measures. As noted in the reference guide, each hardscape surface is only counted once, even if it is addressed in multiple strategies. The first common instance of double counting is when trees are shading hardscape. It's easy to count the solar reflectance of the whole parking lot in this example, and then also count the tree shade over that parking lot. The second instance of double counting is where planters sit on a courtyard. Again, it is easy to claim the solar reflectance of the whole courtyard and then the area shaded by planter boxes on top of that. In both these instances, you would adjust the paved area claimed for the courtyard and parking lot to subtract the area shaded by the trees and planters, which is 150 square meters in this example. That amount is then removed from the courtyard pavers and parking lot. The form won't check this for you, so a quick cross-check is best. Manually add up the non-weighted areas that you entered in the last column. In this case, they now add up to 1400 square meters since we removed the double counting of the shaded paved areas. That figure cannot be more than the denominator, which is the total project paving area. It can be less, since we might choose not to include all hardscape areas in our mitigation strategies. But the non-weighted hardscape areas should never be more than the total project paving area. Remember, this credit's requirements are focused on mitigating hardscape and roof areas. So don't include the shading of the trees provided over landscaping, but only over hardscape. The third issue is a simple verification that the requirements are met. The LEED form doesn't show the score. There is just this little note at the end of the summary table that reminds us that the weighted sum has to be more than the sum of the paving and roof areas. Weighted sum of the measures employed to mitigate heat island must be more than the sum of the project paving and roof areas. The form won't check it for you, so confirm the first is more than the second noted here. And that's it for our common errors with this credit. If you have questions on any of these issues we discussed today, please don't hesitate to reach out to LEED Coach Canada. Thank you for listening.